So under topics 1, we learn about types of data. This one show will come out in the exam. That is giving me danger in objective question. Nah, faham tak? Line paper 2, I think is very easy objective because your answer is either 6 or 7. Dalam jawapan ada 6 or 7. Sure, either 6 or 7. So macam mana nak tahu 6 or 7? You go through the 3 steps. Then you get the accurate answer. Dengar kan? Lagi satu in the exam, remember objective means 45 minutes to answer 20 questions. The time is important tau, time factor. Busur paling ketat di exam is masa. So you cannot waste a lot of time. Kalau one question you cannot answer, you better skip. Clear not? Better skip and move on. Yeah? So any questions so far ni? Hari ni kita nak practice sikit ni sana. So, okay. So, next step is to decide. Kita dah tahu the class tadi dah. We know ni, first class is what, second class is what, third class is what. So the next thing is, in the first class tu ada berapa frequency. Understand? How many numbers are in the first class, how many are in the second class. So what we do, that is me mistake lah, I actually made mistake ni. Patutnya I decided 31 to 40, so the next slide should be what? 31-40. I made a mistake. I forgot to change. Yeah? Actually, this is supposed to be 31-40, 41-50, 51-60, and so on. Nanti I will make the amendment and post up in the blog or Facebook again. I change it as well. I forgot to change it. But anyway, the step is what? Between 30 to 39, the easiest is like this. You cannot look at class 1, then cari satu-satu-satu, you make a lot of mistake. So what you do is you start from kiri, top to bottom. Mana yang you dah tanda tu pangkal, potong lembut tu supaya dia repeat dari kiri. For example, 35 sure dalam first class lah. Clear not? So bila dah pakai 35, you potong 35. Wow. Then second number 65 potong dan tanda 65 ni tanda satu tanda. Satu tanda maknanya dah bilang sekali lah. Then next one 65 lagi masuk sini tanda yang dulu. So tanda 4 kali yang kelima palang. And then cross. So we know that every cross will represent 5. Dengar tak? Every cross is 5. So last bila kita dah buat semua ni, it's called tally counting. Huh? So we found that the first class the frequency is 1. Then second class we got 4, third class we got 7 and so on. Huh? But the most important thing, lepas kita jumlah semua ni, the total must be what? 50. Kalau tak cukup, it means sure tercicir satu nombor. Satu dua nombor. Are you clear now? Okay, ini kena buat lah. Dalam exam, kena buat ni juga. Yeah, so you see ya, the process of developing a frequency table ni memakan masa. Anyway, you got to practice. Huh? Practice many times. Okay, so this is our frequency table. Yang kita nampak just now I told you from number 2 tadi. I show you the table kan, frequency table. This is what you want. Tapi of course remember, this method we use are manual, betul tak? Tapi sekarang we got a lot of software like SPSS. You key in all the SPSS, the software will tell you what is the number. The software will create a table for you. Nanti ada masa I will show you. Now today we got no time. I will skip that part. So when actually doing research, we don't have to do all this. These are all the old method we have to learn so that we understand the method of doing statistics. Faham tak? Tapi once you understand foundationally, when you use SPSS next time, easy for you. But say you understand how to use it. Yeah? Okay. Next. We go to the next part in topic 2. We talk about class boundary. This one important, class boundary ni. Every class just now, let's say between 31 to 40, 31 to 40, we say the limit, the lower limit is what? Between 31 to 40, what is the lower limit?
31.
Upper limit?
40.
Then we have the term called boundary. Boundary ni dia lain sikit. Boundary, let's say 31 to 40, first class. Second class, 41 to 50. Faham tak semua? Class yang pertama, 31 to 40. Class 8, 41 to 50.